మైక్ ఉంది కదా. ఓం గణానాం త్వా గణపతిహం హవామహే కవిం కవీనాముపమశ్రవస్తమం జ్యేష్ఠరాజం బ్రహ్మణాం బ్రహ్మణస్పతాన శృణ్వన్నోతిభిః సీదసాదనం శ్రీమహాగణాధిపతయే నమః. గురుర్బ్రహ్మా గురుర్విష్ణుః గురుర్దేవో మహేశ్వరః గురుస్సాక్షాత్ పరం బ్రహ్మ తస్మై శ్రీగురవే నమః. సదాశివసమారంభాం శంకరాచార్యమ్యమాం అస్మదాచార్యపర్యంతం వందే గురు పరంపరాం. ఓం. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వీఆర్ ఇన్ ది సిక్స్త్ చాప్టర్ ఆఫ్ ది వేదాంత పంచదశి, అండ్ ఇన్ దట్ సిక్స్త్ చాప్టర్ వీ రెడ్ శ్లోక నంబర్ 66 ఇన్ ది లాస్ట్ క్లాస్. And the discussion is about what exactly is the real Atma. And some people said right from gross to subtle, that is the process in which Vidyaranya is going on. And the grossest idea was that the body itself is the physical body, the sthula sharira. Sthula sharira itself is Atma, that is one branch of Lokayatas and Pamaras. And they also said, okay, Annamaya, Savayesha Purusha Annamaya, they also tried to quote the Shruti. And again, some other people, they said, no, but the body cannot be the Atma because there is something called Indriya. These Indriyas, when they are dying, then again, though the body is there, when the Indriya is not there, it is of no use. So, Indriya is the Atma, that is Indriyatma Vadinaha. And again, they also said, Indriyas, why are the Atma? Because this Indriyanam Kalaha, that is Paraspara Spardha, that is, Aham Shreyase Vivadamana, that is what we see in that Upanishad. Aham Shreyase, in that Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, they just say, okay, I am superior. When they are fighting like that, how can you say that they are Achetana? So they are the Chetana things. Then again, another next level, people said, no, Hiranyam, prana is more important because unless prana is there, the Indriyas are themselves not there. So that is what some other people, they said, that is Hiranyagarbhaha Pranatma Vadinaha Eva Muchire. Because even when the mind is withdrawn in Sushupti, even when the Indriyas are totally withdrawn, even then the prana continues. And if the prana goes away, then the person is no longer there. So that is why they said Pranatma Vadinaha. Then again, next level, they said Mana Atma Vadinaha. We are now coming to this Mana Atma Vadinaha. Pranatma Vadinaha, we saw yesterday. That is Prano Jagarti Suptepi Pranashreshthyadikam Srutam Kosha Pranamayas Samyak Visarena Prapanchitaha. There, in that commentary, there was one line from Chandogya Upanishad. Tat Prane Prasanna Udatishthat Taduktham Abhavat Tadetaduktham. So I was telling you that I will just check up the meaning of uktham. Uktham is another word. Uktham has several meanings in the Advaita Vedanta. One meaning is pranam. Uktham also means pranam. It also refers to a group of ruks. Rukveda, and there are so many suktas. Each sukta is having so many ruks. Ruk is a mantra. So a group of ruks, it is called shastram. Shastram, there is also another meaning. Shastram is a weapon which you hold in your hand. Shastram, that is a normal meaning which we all know. But another meaning of shastram in Vedanta, in the Vedic literature, is that it is a group of ruks which are used by the hota while offering some oblations into the fire. So the somayaji, In that Somayaga, this is the group of mantras which are used at the time of offering oblation. And there in the Chandogya Upanishad, the context was about the importance of prana. So that is what is the meaning of that. Pranasya Shreshtriyadikam Shruyate Anyontaratma Pranamayaha. He also quoted that Taittiriya Upanishad. So that is how we read the commentary of Sloka number 66. We have to go to 67. In that 67, he is talking about mana, manas. So prana may be there, but manas is more important, he says. Because prana shakti is merely kriya shakti, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I have got a lot of energy. I have energy, but then I don't know where to invest my energy, how to use my energy. Suppose even a big man like a Schwarzenegger, so he has got lot many muscles. But it is his mind which controls all that. It is his mind which tells him how to use it. So the mind is more important. So that is what the other people are saying. Mind is the, but that is what is the Ichcha Shakti. And the, this one is only Kriya Shakti. So Ichcha Shakti is superior to this Kriya Shakti. Though Kriya Shakti is very, very important. So this 67th shloka I will read. Mana atmeti manyante upasana para janaha pranasya bhoktruta spashta bhoktrutvam manasastataha. Avatarika says, pranadepi antarasya manasaha atmatvavadino madam darshe, matam darshayati. Atmatvavadinaha. What do the manaha? Manasaha atmatvavadinaha. Mind is the atma. Mind is the real self. So that is what they say. Why? Because pranadapi antarasya manasaha. Pranadapi antaram. It is subtle, more subtle than this akshma, atma, prana. Matam darshayati manaha atma iti. So this shloka says, manaha atma iti manyanta. Manyanta is manyante. Manyante upasana paraha becomes manyanta upasana paraha. Upasana paraha is upasana eva param iti ye manyante te upasana paraha. That is upasana is great. Upasana is supreme. Upasana means it can be worship also. Puja, worship, etc. All those things also can be taken. Whether it is puja or whether it is worship or whether it is upasana, it is the mind which plays an important role in that. Because it is the mind. Mind is the thing which has to be channelized. Puja means an activity in which you have to focus your mind in front of a deity. And again, upasana again is upasana if you are contemplating on the nature of a particular deity. Again, upasana says, we have seen that Taittiriya Upanishad and other Upanishads where Shankaracharya gives a definition for that upasana. Upasana is taila dharavat tulya pratyaya santatihi asankirnacha atat pratyayaihi. Like a stream of thin stream of oil falling from a beaker, poured from a beaker. And it is something which is uninterrupted, it is a thin line, taila dhara. And it's not breaking into globules, it is a thin stream. So like that, a very modern example can be like a laser beam. Laser beam, in normal light, it is all the light waves are scattered. What is the difference between ordinary light and laser beam? There in the laser beam, all the light waves are in one wavelength and they are all in one direction, in the same direction they are going. So that is the speciality. So in that manner the mind has to function. Taila dharavat tulya pratyaya santati asankirna cha atat pratyayaihi, undisturbed or unadulterated by dissimilar thoughts. Similar thoughts, that is the idea of a particular deity, it has to continuously be contemplated upon. So that is what is upasana. So that means mind is very, very important. Mind is the thing which is understanding the nature of the deity. Upasana paraha janaha. And pranasya abhokturta spashta. Pranasya abhokturta. Okay, you are having some rasagulla or some such nice whatever delicious food you like. And is it the prana which likes it? Prana is the consumer. Prana is like your vehicle. Suppose you are having a nice vehicle and then you are driving that vehicle and then you have poured some diesel into the diesel or petrol into that and then that is actually consuming all that. That is the fire. But who is enjoying? You are enjoying and not the diesel. You are going for a picnic and then you are going there, sitting there, enjoying. And it's not your car which is enjoying, you are enjoying. So that is pranasya abhokturta spashta. Prana is not the bhokta. Bhokta means the enjoyer of sukha or dukkha. Whatever happens, whether it is sukha or dukkha, it is the mind which is the enjoyer. So it is the mind which is called the bhokta, that is the enjoyer, bhuja. Bhokta, spashta, it is so clear. It is so clear, it is so apparent that it is the mind which is the bhokta. Then bhokturtvam manasaha tataha. Therefore, bhokturtvam is for manas and not for prana. And whoever is that bhokta, he has to be the boss. In any establishment, whoever is the bhokta, the boss is the main bhokta, isn't it? All of the people are small bhoktas. So like that. So here, upasana paraha, those who consider that upasana is very, very important. Upasana paraha janaha, bhokturtvam, so manaha atma iti manyante. Shloka is clear. There is no commentary on this. Pranasya anatmatve yuktim aha pranasya iti. Pranasya anatmatve yuktim aha. That is to say that prana is not the self. He is giving a logic. Yukti. Yukti is logically he is saying that prana is not the bhokta. It is the manas which is the bhokta. So we have to consider or we have to admit that it is the mind which is the atma. Then another reason also he is giving. Another reason. Manasaha atmatve yukti pratipadikam shrutim aha. So there is also a shruti which is also saying that the mind is very, very important. It is not saying that it is atma. But this shruti can be quoted in order to say that, in order to claim that mind is the atma. That shruti is not saying that mind is atma. Mind is, the shruti is only saying that mind is very, very important. So let me see. Mana eva manushyanam karanam bandha mokshayoho shruto mano mayah koshah tena atme tiritam manah. This line we have heard several times. Mana eva manushyanam karanam bandha mokshayoho. We have heard this line several times. It is said to be from Amruta Bindu Upanishad. Amruta Bindu Upanishad, even the very beginning shlokas. So manaha eva is manaha eva manushyanam karanam bandha mokshayoho. The next second line is bandhaya vishaya sangaha mokshaya avishayam manaha. That is the second line. Bandhaya Vishaya Asangaha. That is Vishayeshu Asaktihi. Asanga is Asakti. Vishayeshu Asaktihi Bandhaya Bhavati. And if you are Nirvishayam Manaha, when the mind becomes Nirvishayam, when it has withdrawn from all the Vishayas, then Mokshaya Kalpate. So that is the context in which it has been told. The mind is an instrument which, when it is an extrovert, externally bound, let us say, extrovert and introvert again are psychological terms from psychology. When the mind is externally oriented, that is, oriented towards all the external objects, then naturally it is going and it is there in the Vishaya. Vishaya also, we have seen the etymology of that Vishaya. Vishaya is Shi Bandhane. It comes from the root, Shi Bandhane. Vishaya is something, the moment you take something, you like it, you fall in love with this. Suppose there is a better phone, better, I fall in love with that, this is bandhana. Vishi, bandhane, from that root. So all these vishayas, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha, all the vishayas, they do bind a person. I see some nice thing and I like it. So that is it. So manushyanam karanam bandha mokshayo, bandhaya vishaya sangaha, mokshaya avishayam smrutam. Avishayam manaha, mana is assumed there. Mokshaya avishayam smrutam. Avishayam. So, karanam bandhamokshayoho shruto manomayah koshaha shrutaha manomayah koshaha evam shrutaha. That is, manomayah kosha has been described by, like this in the shruti. Manomayah koshaha evam shrutaha. Tena atma iti iritam manaha. Tena manaha atma iti iritam. Iritam is uktam. That is the reason why people have told that mind is the real self. Then manasahatmatve oka tika is tasmadva etasmat pranamayat anyontaratma manomayaha iti shrutyantarat. What is that shrutyantaram? That is shruti. We have read this thing. That is Taittiriya Upanishad, that panchakosha viveka. We have seen that tasmadva etasmat pranamayat, more subtle than this pranamaya kosha, there is another level of cognition. And in fact, Buddhist philosophy also, they also talk about pancha skandhas and what not, various skandhas, jnana skandha, vijnana skandha and all that. So, pranamayat, anyaha antara atma, manomaya, there is another inner self called manomaya. This is what Taittiriya Upanishad says. Iti shrutyantaram darshayati, shrutaha phalitamaha tena. Tena, therefore, it is claimed to be the self by those manatma vadinaha, not by Siddhanti. Manatmavadinaha, they claim. And now he is coming to this Vijnanatmavadinaha. Vijnana has two meanings here. Vijnana is that buddhi. Buddhi is that intellect. Intellect is nishayatmika buddhi. Sankalpa vikalpatmakam manaha. And nishayatmika buddhi is one. Aham is more referring to the aham shabda here and not to buddhi. Aham, the I vrutti, that aham vrutti is there, isn't it? Aham vrutti is something which is directly known to us. I, that is directly known to us. Aham asmi, that is directly known to us. So that is the reason, that is what he is saying. I'll read the avatarika. Manasopi antarasya vijnanasya atmatva vadino bauddhasya matam darshayati. Atmasya atmatva vadino bauddhasya matam darshayati. So there is another one branch of Buddha, Buddhist. దట్ ఈస్ ది క్షణిక విజ్ఞానవాదినః క్షణిక విజ్ఞానవాదినః వాట్ డూ దే సే దేర్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ మోర్ సటిల్ దెన్ ద మైండ్ ద మన మైండ్ మైండ్ మీన్స్ వీఆర్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ మనస్ లెవెల్ మైండ్ వీ షుడ్ నాట్ టేక్ ఇట్ టు ఇన్క్లూడ్ దట్ బుద్ధి అండ్ ఆల్ దోస్ థింగ్స్ అండ్ వీఆర్ జస్ట్ టాకింగ్ అట్ ది లెవెల్ ఆఫ్ మైండ్ మనస్ బియాండ్ దట్ మనస్ దేర్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ కాల్డ్ అహం వృత్తి దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ దే సే విజ్ఞానం ఆత్మేతి పర ఆహు క్షణికవాదినః యతో విజ్ఞానమూలత్వం మనసో గమ్యతే స్ఫుటం. సపోజ్ యూ హ్యావ్ గాట్ మనస్, యు ఆర్ సీయింగ్ వేరియస్ థింగ్స్, వేరియస్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ బై మనస్, విత్ ద హెల్ప్ ఆఫ్ మనస్ యు ఆర్ సీయింగ్, యు ఆర్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్, యు ఆర్ లైకింగ్, డిస్లైకింగ్ ఎట్సెట్రా. అండ్ అల్టిమేట్లీ హూ ఈస్ ద బాస్ హూ ఈస్ కమాండింగ్ యువర్ మనస్, మనస్ అండ్ ఇంద్రియాస్ టు గెట్ ఇట్? ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఐ. ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఐ విచ్ ఈస్ కమాండింగ్. ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఐ ఆర్ ద ఈగో విచ్ ఈస్ ఆర్డరింగ్ ద మైండ్ ఆర్ డైరెక్టింగ్ ద మైండ్. విజ్ఞానమూలత్వం మనసా గమ్యతే, ది సెకండ్ లైన్ ఈస్ సేయింగ్ ఐ వాంట్ టు బి దిస్, ఈవెన్ ఐ వాంట్ దిస్ ఆర్ ఐ వాంట్ టు బి దిస్, వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్, ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఐ విచ్ సేస్. విజ్ఞానం ఆత్మా ఇది పరే ఆహు, పరే ఆహు అగైన్ ఇస్ పర ఆహు ఇస్ పరే ఆహు సంతి. పరే మీన్స్ సమ్ అదర్స్. పరే క్షణికవాదిన ఆహు, క్షణికవాదిన ఈస్ దర్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ద డాక్ట్రిన్ ఆఫ్ మొమెంటరీనెస్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్. మొమెంటరీనెస్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ ఇఫ్ యూ సీ దట్ దేర్ అగైన్ వీఆర్ సపోజ్ టు రీడ్. అఫ్ కోర్స్ హియర్ విద్యారణ్య ఈస్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ ఇన్ టు ద డీటెయిల్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్స్, హీ ఈస్ జస్ట్ మెన్షనింగ్ ఇట్ అండ్ హీఈస్ జస్ట్ గోయింగ్ అహెడ్ మెన్షనింగ్ ఇట్ అండ్ గోయింగ్ అహెడ్ సేయింగ్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ రైట్. బట్ ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు సీ దేర్ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు రియలీ గో ఇన్ టు దోస్ పర్టికులర్ సిద్ధాంతాస్. వీ హ్యావ్ పర్టికులర్లీ రీడ్ ద బుద్ధిస్ట్ ఫిలాసఫీ, బికాస్ బుద్ధిస్ట్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో దే ఆర్ నాట్ పీపుల్ హూ హ్యావ్ టు బి డిస్మిస్డ్ అండ్ దే హ్యావ్ డన్ వెరీ సీరియస్ థింకింగ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ అండ్ దెర్ ఈస్ సో మచ్ ఆఫ్ క్లోజ్నెస్ బిట్వీన్ బుద్ధిస్ట్ ఐడియాస్ అండ్ ది వేదాంత. సో దట్ వీఆర్ నాట్ సపోజ్ టు టోటలీ డిస్మిస్ దెమ్ ఆన్ ద ఫేస్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్. వీ హ్యావ్ టు టేక్ ఇట్ సీరియస్లీ. సో విజ్ఞా దట్ క్షణికవాదిన మొమెంటరీనెస్ ఆఫ్ కాన్షియస్నెస్, ద పీపుల్ హూ సే దట్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ ఈస్ దేర్ బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మొమెంటరీ. ఎవ్రీ మినిట్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ న్యూ జ్ఞానం అరైజింగ్. ద మినిట్ ఐ సే ఐ, దెన్ యువర్ ఓల్డ్ ఐ ఈస్ గాన్. ఐ మీన్స్ క్యాపిటల్ ఐ, నాట్ ఈ వై. అండ్ ద మొమెంట్ ఐ సే వెన్ ఐ సీ ది కప్, ఐ సీ దిస్ కప్ అండ్ ద నెక్స్ట్ సెకండ్ ద కప్ ఈస్ గాన్, ద ఓల్డ్ కప్ ఈస్ గాన్ అండ్ ద న్యూ కప్ ఈస్ దేర్, ద న్యూ జ్ఞానం ఈస్ దేర్. అగైన్ ది నెక్స్ట్ మూమెంట్ ద న్యూ జ్ఞానం, అనదర్ నెక్స్ట్ మూమెంట్ ద న్యూ జ్ఞానం. సో దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ జ్ఞాన సంతానం. సంతానం ఈస్ ఎ స్ట్రీమ్. జ్ఞాన సంతానం ఈజ్ గివింగ్ మీ ఎన్ ఇల్యూషన్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ సీయింగ్ దిస్ కప్ కంటిన్యూస్లీ. సో అకార్డింగ్ టు బుద్ధిస్ట్, వెన్ ఐఎమ్ సీయింగ్ ద కప్, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ సీయింగ్ ద కప్ కంటిన్యూస్లీ. ఇట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ ఎన్ ఇల్యూషన్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ సీయింగ్ ద కప్ కంటిన్యూస్లీ, బికాస్ ద మూమెంట్ ఐ సీ ద ఇట్ ఈస్ దేర్, ద నెక్స్ట్ మూమెంట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ దేర్. సో బికాస్ క్షణ విజ్ఞాన ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ క్షణకాల ఈజ్ దట్ లైఫ్ టైమ్ అండ్ ద నెక్స్ట్ మినిట్ అనదర్ కప్ ఈజ్ బార్న్. నెక్స్ట్ మినిట్ నాట్ మినిట్ నెక్స్ట్ క్షణం అనదర్ కప్ ఈజ్ బార్న్, నెక్స్ట్ నిమిషం అనదర్ కప్. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ లైక్ ద సినిమాటోగ్రఫీ. యు నో ద ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఆఫ్ సినిమాటోగ్రఫీ. ఇన్ సినిమాటోగ్రఫీ హౌ డూ యూ గెట్ ఎ మూవింగ్ పిక్చర్? ఆల్ సో మెనీ స్టిల్స్ అబౌట్ 16 stills per second or something like that. That is something called principle of persistence of vision, isn't it? In science, they talk about the principle of persistence of vision. In cinemas also, we see certain actions in slow motion. Suppose the hero hits the villain slowly flies and then he falls there. So that is, or and how is that illusion created? When the hero or heroine they are dancing, how is that illusion created? Their actual performance is actually shot in so many stills, and all those stills are successively shown. When they are shown in a quick succession, that quick succession means in 1 second about 16 continuous stills have to be there, then the mind captures the picture as a continuous action. The mind cannot see the distinction, and the mind captures the continuity of that action. So similarly, it is somewhat similar to that, almost similar to that. The Buddhists, they talk about that long ago. So Shanikavadinaha yataha, because vijnanamulatvam manasaha gamyate sputam. Manasaha vijnanamulatvam sputam gamyate is the anvaya. Manasaha vijnanamulatvam Sputam Gamyate, that is, the mind is under the control of Vijnanam, the mind is under the control of ego, it is so clearly seen. The mind is very clearly under the control of the ego, because the mind is seeing so many things. It is the ego which says, no, no, I want this, or I want to be this. All these things, it is the ego which dictates. Then, commentary is not much. Vijnanasya antaratve yukti maha yata iti. And how is he saying that Vijnanam is more subtle than Manas? Because Vijnana is the origin, or rather Vijnana is the thing which is commanding the Manas. Vijnana is the thing which is commanding the Manas. So therefore Vijnana is more subtle than the Manas. And in fact we see in that Kathopanishad also, Vijnana Sarathiriyastu, Manah Pragrahavan Naraha. So, Indriyas are going like horses, and when the Indriyas are going like horses, it is the mind they are like the reins. Manah Pragrahavan. Pragraha is reins. Paggam we say. Telugu word Paggam is that Pragraha. So, Manah Pragrahavan Naraha. Then who is the person controlling? Vijnana Sarathi. That ego. That is, ego is the Sarathi. Vijnana Sarathi Riyastu Manah Pragrahavan Naraha. Sodhvanah param apnoti, something like that. It is there. There is that mantra is there. So sodhvanah param apnoti, he moves in the right path. So that is what they say. So mind is something which is under the control of the vijnana or the ego. Then he is also continuing one more point there to explain the distinction between the manomaya kosha and vijnanamaya kosha. There can be a doubt that I'll read the avatar, you can't explain. Vijnana Manashabdavachyasya Antahkaranasya. That is the Antahkarana, which is also called Vijnana, that is ego. It is also called Manas. When the Antahkarana, the same Antahkarana is called both as ego and also as Manas, that is the meaning of it. Vijnana Manashabdavachyasya Antahkaranasya. Ekatvat, because it is one and the same. This Antahkaranam is one and the same because there are two names for that. That is, one is called Vijnana and another is called Manas, ego level and mind level. Katham Mano Vijnana Yoho Karyakarana Bhavaha. How do you say that there is a sort of Karyakarana Bhava between mind and the ego? The above sentence, the above shloka, it is implying a sort of Karyakarana Bhava. Vijnana Moolatvam Manaso Gamyate Sputam. Manasaha Vijnana Moolatvam Gamyate. That is, Vijnanam is the origin and mind is the next level. Origin means Vijnanam is the Moolam. Or rather, Vijnanam is the thing which is directing the Manas. So, that is the Karanam and this is the Karyam. So, how do you establish this Karya Karana Bhava? So, that is what is the doubt. Katham Mano Vijnana Yoho Karya Karana Bhavaha. Iti Ashankya. Tam upapadayitum tayor bhedam tavat darshayati. In order to explain it, or in order to upapadayitum means in order to postulate it, tayoho bhedam tavat darshayati. He is showing the distinction between the manomaya kosha and the vijnanamaya kosha. So here, what is it he is saying? In the vijnanamaya kosha, vijnanam is that ego level, that aham vrutti is there. Aham vrutti. Vrutti, you know the word meaning of, we all know the meaning of vrutti. Vrutti is the mind is in a particular state or a thought frame. That is what is called vrutti. Vartate anaya iti vrutti, isn't it? I see an object and my mind assumes the shape of that object. So my mind is having that kappu vrutti, kappakara vrutti, let us say. Kap, let us say, instead of kappu, let me say chashaka. Chashaka is the Sanskrit word, so chashakakara vrutti. So this chashakakara vrutti, and the moment I look at you, I am having that your akara vrutti. So that is what is happening. So the mind is vartate. It is in that state of thought frame, let us say. It is in that thought frame. So aham vrutti is number one. Then idam vrutti, I am seeing this. When I say I am seeing this, there is an aham vrutti and there is an idam vrutti. Idam vrutti is there. And idam is something which is not different from me. In fact, we have seen it in, what is this? 13th chapter of Gita also. Idam shariram kaunteya kshetramitya vidhiyate. Because the entire body-mind complex can be objectified. It can be seen apart from your real self. So that is the reason why the whole body mind complex is something which is idam, it is kshetram, it is your field in which your the ego is actually not ego, it is the real self. It is just having it as a sort of field, and your karma phala, etc., etc., they are all born there. So, and that what is the field and what is the kshetrajna, there we see the discussion. So there are two things, there are two vrittis here. There is one aham vritti and idam vritti. And which is primary? This aham vritti is primary. It is only when I know that aham, I, then the question of idam comes. Visually, we don't know child psychology, but anyway, child, suppose we see the children. A few months old baby, the baby, what does it do? The baby looks at things, maybe I don't know whether it really has that sense of ego or not. But after some time, after a few months, it will develop a sense of ego. And you give it something and then you ask it back, it will not give. So that aham vritti is slowly forming into that. And we also say, oh, you are good, you are cute, you are beautiful, etc., etc. So then we say that then again that ego, that boosting is there. So naturally that ego is developing in that. And idam vritti, no, I want this, I want that, I want that. That idam vritti is depending on that. So aham vritti is something which is primary and idam vritti is something which is secondary. So that is what we are going to see. I will read the shloka. Aham vrittir idam vrittir ityantahkaranam dvidha vijnanam syad aham vrittihi. Idam vrittir mano bhavet. So this aham vrittihi, idam vrittihi iti antahkaranam dvidha. Dvidha means twofold. Antahkaranam can be understood in two ways, seen in two levels. That is, one is that aham vritti and the other is idam vritti. The thought of I and the thought of this. The I notion, let us say, capital I. The I notion and this notion. That is it. I consciousness and this consciousness, whatever it is. So that is, iti antahkaranam dvidha. Then vijnanam syad aham vritti. What we call vijnanam, what we call ego, is that aham vritti. And idam vritti mano bhavet. Then manas is looking at all the objects. Idam vritti, this is the chair, this is that, I am seeing with this manas. All this idam vritti is taking place with this manas only. And in fact this manas also is seen by the aham. My mind, we say, my mind is not so well today, my mind is not good today, my mind is happy today. So all these things. So my mind, so that I, this ego is also seeing its mind, distancing its mind. So that is what we see. So all the knowledge of things is happening through the mind, plus the mind also is seen by the ego. That is it. Mind is commanded by the ego. So tavat darshayate aham vrittirti. So there is no further commentary on this. Then the same thing is explaining. The same thing is explaining in the next shloka, 71st shloka. The same karya karana bhava. Karya karana bhava is one is the cause and the other is the karana, the effect. One is the cause and the effect. Aham vritti is the cause and idam vritti is the effect. So 71st shloka I will read. This 71st shloka, what it says is this idam vritti and aham vritti, two things are there. The seed for idam vritti. The very seed for idam vritti is that aham vritti. So that means aham vritti is the karanam and idam vritti is the cause. The seed for this tree is something else. When I say that seed that is the cause and this is the effect, it is like that.
Aham pratyaya bijatvam idam vritteriti sputam aviditva swamatmanam bahyam vetti natu kvachit. Aham pratyaya bijatvam idam vrittehe. Bhava asti, it is putam, asti borrow there. Idam vrittehe aham pratyaya bijatvam asti, it is putam drushtam. Idam vrittehe means what? For this idam vritti, for this idea of this, for this consciousness, for this consciousness, aham pratyaya bijatvam, the bija is aham pratyaya. The bija or the seed is that aham pratyaya. That is, unless that seed is there, this will not grow. So this aham pratyaya is the seed and this idam vritti is the effect. So when that is so, that is idam vritti originates from that aham vritti. In other words, idam vritti originates from that aham vritti. So aham pratyaya bijatvam idam vrittehe iti sputam. Iti sputam means it's so clear that
this idam vritti is something which is having its bijam or root or seed in that aham vritti. So aham vritti is the thing from which this idam vritti is originating. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Then aviditva svam atmanam bahyam vetinatu kvachit kaschit manushyaha svam atmanam aviditva, without knowing his own, without first realizing that he is there, I, without saying that I, simply you just don't go to some place and then you don't say this, you don't say. You say, I want this. Of course, you can also say this, that is a different thing. But that I is presumed. I want this. So it is that. Aviditva swamatmanam, without knowing about his own ego, without knowing or realizing or without being conscious of one's own self. I am conscious of my own self when I select a thing, when I go to the shop. I may just point out, okay, you please take it out. That means I am conscious of my own presence, that ego. So that is it. Aviditva swamatmanam means without knowing or without being conscious of one's own self. Bahyam vetyanatu kvachit, the other, the external thing is not seen. External thing is not put in the proper context. It is only when you are aware of your own self, then self, not in the self, that self in the Brahma, etc., not that Atma, Brahma Jnana, we are not talking about Brahma Jnana. We are talking about at a very lower, at an ordinary level, at a very empirical level. So one has to be aware of his own self, that if I am there, and then only he will say, I want this, I want that, etc., etc. So swamatmanam aviditva bahyam veti natu kvachit. So the I notion is something which is primary, and this notion is something which is secondary. So even a child, as we were talking, even a child that develops that aham vritti, only when it develops aham vritti, then it will develop idam vritti. That is how we see this. Then here the commentary, tayoh karyakarana bhavamaha aham pratye bijatvam iti tadeva upapada iti aviditva iti. Upapadanam means postulating. He is just postulating. These are all various logical steps or corollaries. He first says something, from that he is drawing some corollary or various logical steps, we can say. Aham vrityudaya abhave idam vrityudaya idam vrityanudayat aham vrityudaya abhave. When this aham vritti is not there, idam vritti also is not there. It is only when that aham vritti is there, then idam vritti comes. Something I am distinguishing from myself. I need it. So that is it. So aham vritti udaya bhave idam vritti anudayat anayoho karyakarana bhavaha ityarthaha. For these two, karyakarana bhavaha vartate ityarthaha. Then the next shloka, then avatarika says, tasya vijnanasya kshanikatve anubhavam pramanayati. So that Vijnana, now he is telling about this Kshanika Vijnanavada. Kshanika Vijnanavada is, again I was telling you, this principle or doctrine of momentariness. And in fact, we get a lot of material even from the internet nowadays. If you go to an authentic website, suppose you go to the website of Buddhism themselves, then you get some authentic articles about what exactly is the Kshanika Vijnanavada. It is otherwise called yoga. It is called Yogachara school. Yogachara. We know that Buddhists, there are two main branches, and two main branches are again divided into four branches. Two main branches are this Theravada and Mahayana. Theravada is, the original word for Thera is Sthavira. Sthaviravada. Sthavira means elder. Sthavira is elder person. Sthavira gradually became Thera in Pali. Theravada. So Theravada is the older school. Theravada is the older school where you find a lot of philosophical speculation and all that. Later, this Mahayana also, the other thing is called Mahayana. Mahayana included large number of people. Theravada included only a small group of monks, etc. This Mahayana included the entire group of people, society and various sects of people and all that. It developed into this Yantra, Tantra and so many other things. So they also had their own metaphysics and epistemology and all these things. So unless we study it properly, this is only just a mere mention of that. And Vidyaranya is not going deep into that, and we are also not going deep into that, because if we have to go deep into that, we have to study that Buddhist literature very, very thoroughly. Without reading that Buddhist literature thoroughly, I can't say. So, anyway, just some supplementary reading we can do. Supplementary reading, we can just go to internet, say, see what is the doctrine of momentariness. So, there are one or two essays, so that we understand this shloka in a much better way. So, this vijnanasya chanikatve anubhavam pramanayati. So, vijnanam is chanikam. So, for that, their people, their siddhanti, the chanikavadi. Kshanikavadi, he is giving some logic. Kshane kshane janmanasha vaham vrutter mitavyataha vijnanam kshanikam tena svaprakasham svatomitehe. So, this see this shloka. Kshane kshane janmanashau aham vruttehe mitavyataha. Yataha is because aham vruttehe, for this aham vrutti, then janmanashau. Aham vrutti is just originating and dying. So this is the one siddhanta. Why? You may not feel like that. You may not immediately agree. But then, they have their own logical arguments to say that this aham vrutti, this notion of I, is just every second, every shanam, it is appearing and dying. So aham vruttehe janmanashau kshane kshane drushyate. Kshane kshane, every second, it is born and dying. So, because urtehe mitau. Mitau means known. These two are known. Mana, miti, ma, from ma dhatu only mitau. Mitau is dvivachana. Mitau yataha, because this origin and death of this aham urti is seen every minute. Not minute again is the wrong word. Every moment. Every moment we are seeing the origin and death of this aham vrutti. So that is the first line. Because of that reason, shani vijnanam kshanikam tena. For that reason, we have to conclude that this vijnanam which originates in the mind, that aham vrutti and also this adham vrutti, when aham vrutti itself is momentary, its cause, its effect also is momentary, isn't it? When the aham vrutti itself is momentary, naturally the idam vrutti also becomes momentary. So vijnanam kshanikam tena, then what is the next step they draw? Svaprakasham svata, svato mitehe, because it is known by oneself, svato svataha mitehe, because it is known by oneself, it is svaprakasham. There is no need for anybody else to say that I exist is something which is svaprakasham, I know. This is one important thing which is we also agree. Jnanam is something which is svaprakasha. We had some discussion in the very beginning about Chaitanyasya svaprakasha, why it is called svaprakasha. Because if we say that it is paraprakasha, then that has to be illumined by somebody else. It has to be illumined by something else. So it leads to anavastha dosha. And if you say that no, one chaitanya is illumined by something else, there is what is called anyonyashraya dosha. No, it is illumined by itself, that is atmashraya dosha. To avoid all those things, we have concluded that chaitanyam is something which is svaprakasha, it is self-evident. There is no need for any other agent to illuminate. So something, I, notion, it is something, it is svaprakasha. So svaprakasham svatomitehe, because it is known by oneself, it is something which we have to accept it as svaprakasha or self-luminous. This self-luminous we also accept, but only thing is we don't accept that it is momentary. That is the point. Chane chane janmanashau janmanashavaham vrutte. Janmanashavaham vrutte is janmanashau aham vruttehe. Aham vruttehe janmanashau chane chane dushyete. Mitau. Dushyete or mitau. No. Yataha, because of that, vijnanam kshanikam. Is this sentence clear? So, what we see as this aham is only an illusion, they say. It is this stream. We have just an illusion of a sort of continuous nature of knowledge. What we think that I am seeing it continuously, it is only an illusion. There is an illusion, there is a continuation of knowledge. So, but otherwise it is not, the knowledge is not continuous. Continuous nature of knowledge, it is not there. So it is a stream, as I said, that vijnana santanam. And every moment you are changing, every moment you are a new person, that is it. Then, Tasya vijnanasya, tasya vijnanasya kshanikatve anubhavam pramanayati. So vijnanam is kshanikam. For that he is telling his own logic, anubhava. Just as we are talking about our anubhava, he is also telling about his anubhava. Kshane kshane iti. Kshanikatvam upapadya swaprakashatvam upapadayati. So he first postulates the kshanikatvam, then again postulates the swaprakashatvam. Vedanta accepts the swaprakashatvam. It does not accept the kshanikatva. That is the main difference. We accept the swaprakashatva. Prakasha is something which is also there in the Upanishads. This is the biggest problem. The biggest problem is Upanishads also say a lot many things which are told again in the Buddhists. So Buddhists say, no, you have copied from us. Upanishads say, you have copied from us. So the same people were there in both groups, because in the Upanishads also all these rishis etc. were there. And when Buddha first of all came out with some ideas, and who were his students? His students were all Brahmins and such people only. All Brahmins only, they were his students. So naturally the same meta-Brahminical ideas and metaphysical ideas, they could have gone into that. So we are not very sure whether Buddha himself told all these things or whether the Brahmins only readjusted their spectacles. We do not know. Their ideas of Upanishads were already there. And there were also people who were feeling about the importance of jnanam, not much about this mimamsakas who were doing all this yajnas and then killing animals and all that. These people probably they didn't want it. They did not think that was the main message of the Vedas. So that is it. So shane shane iti shanikattu parsa swaprakashatvam upapadayati swaprakasham iti svenaiva pramitatvat ityarthaha. Svenaiva pramitatvat means it is illumined by oneself, it is known to oneself. Pramitatvat, known by oneself. Well, we told you otherwise it will lead to anavastha dosha, or one aham vritti is illumining the another aham vritti, etc. is gone. So this again swaprakasha is something which is very close to our Advaita philosophy. Then 73rd sloka, vijnanasya atmatve agamah pramanam ityaha. So for this, okay, sometimes though the Buddhists they don't accept the authority of the Vedas, sometimes when it is convenient they say that your Veda also is saying the same thing. So that is what he says, vijnanasya atmatve agamah, agamam is Veda, is pramanam ityaha, vijnanamaya iti. Vijnanamaya koshoyam jiva ityagama jaguhu. Sarva samsara yetasya janmanasha sukhadikaha. Ayam vijnanamaya koshaha. Vijnanamaya koshoyam is ayam vijnanamaya koshaha. This vijnanamaya kosha is jiva. Iti agamaha jaguhu. Agamaha means the Vedas, they say. Why? Janmanasha sukhadikaha sarva samsaraha yetasya eva. Anvaya is janma nasha sukhadikaha sarva samsara. The whole samsara. Samsara means the whole, all our bondages and all that. All these bondages, etc. And also janma, nasha, sukha, dukkha, happiness, misery. All these things. Love, hate and all these things. They belong to whom? Of this vijnanamaya. This ego, ego self, ego only. It is experiencing all this love, hate, sukha, dukkha and all these things. Sarva samsaraha etasya. Etasya vijnanamayana mayasya eva. So that is the point. Janmanasha sukhadikaha sarva samsaraha. Janmanasha sukhadikaha is the adjective for this samsara. Samsara is the main word. And janmanasha sukhadikaha is the adjective. That is the samsara which is characterized by birth, death and various types of sukha, dukkha, etc. is for this gentleman who vijnanamaya kosha. That is it. Then what is this agama, agama pramana? Again from Taittiriya Upanishad. Here again continuously we are getting references from the Taittiriya Upanishad. Tasmadvaya tasman manomayat. We studied this Taittiriya Upanishad in detail. Tasmadvaya tasman manomayat anyontaratma vijnanamayaha. So that is again from this manomaya, when compared to this manomaya, this vijnanamaya is more subtle. So that is what we have seen. Vijnanam yajnyantanute. Vijnanam yajnyantanute means all our activities. Yajna here relates to all our activities. All our activities, all the human activities depend on this aham only and not on manas. Manas is only a sort of recording instrument. Vijnanam is the thing which is commanding, which is in the commanding seat. So vijnanam yajnyantanute, all the activities are controlled. Yajnam, of course, physical yajna also. All our activity is controlled by this vijnana. Then again, there is another group of Buddhists who are going to another level. That is what is called Shunyavadi. Shunyavadi, they are also called Madhyamikas. Madhyamika philosophy again is what is called, they are Nagarjuna. We know the name of Nagarjuna. He is a Telugu man. Nagarjuna is a Telugu person only. Nagarjuna Konda, which is there in Andhra Pradesh. Nagarjuna is one Telugu man. Dharmakirti is another Telugu man. So, from Telugu land, that is particularly from Andhra region now, there were lot many Buddhists. So probably that is the reason why there is lot many Buddhist stupas are also there. Buddhist stupas are there in Nagatam, not only Nagarjuna Panda, but in Prakasham district and some other places. And in Tirupati, somewhere near Tirupati also, this Dharmakirti was another great Buddhist philosopher who lived. And these are all very, very old people. Dingnaga was another old man, another old philosopher, Buddhist philosopher. So Dingnaga is another philosopher from Andhra only. So next people, what do they say? Bauddha avantara bhedasya shunyavadino matam darshayati. Bauddha avantara bhedasya. Among the Bauddhas, there is avantara bhedam. Avantara bhedam is there is some internal division. Avantara bheda is an internal division. Avantara. Then shunyavadino matam. The matam of that shunyavadi. Shunyavadi is singular here. Shunyavadinaha matam. That is the matam or the theory or doctrine of this Shunyavadi is being shown.
Vijnanam shanikam natma vidyudabhra nimeshavat anyasya anupalabdhatvat shunyam madhyamika jaguhu. Vijnanam shanikam natma vidyudabhra nimeshavat. Vidyut
is not electricity. Vidyut is in Sanskrit, it is lightning. Vidyut that is saudamani vidyut chanchala Amarakosha says something, Prabha something, vidyut saudamani just now I said I myself forgot. Vidyut saudamani chanchala chapala, not chapala, some other word is there. Vidyut saudamani, that is vidyut. Vidyut is the lightning. Lightning, just fraction of a second it is there and then it disappears. And vidyudiva, abhraiva, vidyudabhra nimeshavat, or you can say vidyudabhra, that is lightning in a cloud, you can say like that. And nimeshavat, nimesha is what? Just twinkling of an eye. I just close my eye and flap my eye, that's all. Twinkling of an eye. It is so shanikam, it is so momentary. This vijnanam is so momentary, it cannot be atma. It cannot be atma. Vidyudabhra nimeshavat, it is like vidyudabhra or nimesha. Nimesha, we know the word animesha. Animesha means all the gods, they are called animesha. All the gods, suraha, they are called animesha. Animesha, divisha dolekha, aditinandanaha, that is again the Amarakosha. Animesha means those who do not have that, who never close their eyes. Animesha is they never close their eyes, they are always, their eyes are open. So the meaning is that they are always watchful, they always protect the people. The idea is that they are always guiding and protecting the people, so that is why animesha. So here, vidyudabhra nimeshavat vijnanam shanikam. So hence, na atma, vijnanam cannot be atma. Because it is something which is this ego, the idea of aham vritti is just coming momentarily and it is going. And the earlier Kshanikavada is now refuted by other Buddhists. So that is what we are seeing here. The earlier Kshanikavada, which was told, is now being refuted by another branch of Buddhists who say that this Kshanika Vijnanam is something which is cannot be Atma because it is so momentary, it cannot be Atma. And the second line says, Anyasya Anupalabdhatvat. And there is nothing else to be known. Anyasya Anupalabdhatvat. There is nothing else to be seen. Anyasya Anupalabdhi. Anupalabdhi means non-availability, anupalabdhatvat, not non-existence, but non-availability, shunyam madhyamika jaguhu, madhyamikaha, shunyam iti jaguhu. They say, okay, it is all shunyam, there is something which is totally, there is nothing, there is absolutely nothing. You can't postulate the certainty of existence of anything. You can't postulate that this certainly exists, you just cannot postulate. So that is what they say. Anyasya anupalabdhatva shunyam madhyamikaha jaguhu. All, what all can be postulated is that it is all shunyam, there is nothing. So for here, again here, the commentator could have written something, he has not written anything. Anyasya anupalabdhatvat shunyam madhyamika jaguhu. Is this shloka clear?
Yes.
Okay, then we'll continue in the next class. Harihi Om Tat Sat.